Very good morning all of you, and then we started next part after the units of classification. There is types of classification. In the types of classification, it is most important one. Basically, what happened in NGOs for very early, the classification has been tried to plant as per their use, either useful plant or non-useful plant. This study has been going on. And classification system has been started seriously. So there are three types of the classification systems recognized in use as artificial, natural, and phylogenetic. And each classification have its main own merits and demerits also. And they have been not completely as a single one or independent. They are dependent completely on one to another, and even also overlap one to another. This is most important part. Another thing is that one by one we have to see here the artificial system of classification. Artificial system of classification is a very ancient time. During the pre-Darwinian era, most of the plants are classified on their basis of the useful plant and non-useful plants. And after the systematic study has been started by various scientists, try to classify on the basis of their plant characters, which has to be seen on the particular taxon. So first try to classify these plants, our forefather Theophrastus, forefather of the botany Theophrastus, and he considered that appearance of the plant, appearance that means habit of the plant, is one character. And depending upon the habit of the plants, he classified the whole plant group into three classes as a herb, shrubs, and the trees. That means very few characters means a single characters. So such type of the classification is not used because of they doesn't to determine any relationship evolution pattern of the plant to plant or groups to groups. This is the most important part here. So the classification is completely today out of use or discarded. Then later, the well-known example of this artificial classification system is Tabulus Linnaeus system of classification. He was a father of taxonomy, and he proposed and recognized only two kingdoms in organisms. What I say here, organisms, including the all worlds, where included the plant kingdoms, while animal has to be placed in animal kingdoms. So plants are separated and animals are separated. Linnaeus classified all the plants into 23 classes with flowering plants, baga. 23 classes, and 24th class is non-flowering plants. What are non-flowering plants like? Non-flowering plants including cryptogamic groups, that is algae, fungi, lichen, mosses, and ferns are included in the 24th class. He divided flowering plants on the basis of nature of reproductive organs, that is stamens and carpels. He divided mainly two groups on the basis of unisexual or bisexual flowers, number of stamens, and all these stamens are then again classified as depends upon their numbers. That means single stamens grouped into monandra, two times dandra, three triandra, etc. as a polyandra. So number of carpels in this way also included in this case, and classify the plants completely as the monandra, diandra, etc. So he used reproductive characters, therefore it is also known as sexual system of the classification. MCQ la yu shakte alag lakshat baalan. And second one is a natural system of classification. This is a very important one. After the Darwin in 1859 proposed a theory of biological evolution and predicted or project the present plant have been evolved from those of the existing plants, and these existing plants through series of the modifications. Modification means change in the characters. So series of the modification in response to the change in the environmental conditions. That means as for the environmental conditions, the plants and groups has to be evolved. That is the natural selection. अलग लक्षात नॅचरल सिलेक्शन महत्त्वाचं आहे. ओरिजिनल स्पेसिसमध्ये जे सांगितलेलं आहे ते ऑन दॅट बेसिस पर्टिक्युलरली ऑल द प्लांट्स आर क्लोजली रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर अँड शुड बी नॅचरली ग्रुप टुगेदर. हेन्स इज कॉल्ड एज अ नॅचरल क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टीम. सो ड्यूरिंग द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑल पॉसिबल कॅरेक्टर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गॅनिझम्स आर टेकन टू कन्सिडरेशन. That indicates a natural relationship between them. So on this line of the evolution pattern, plants also classified according to the natural characters which are observed and seen in the taxon or that particular species or a specimen. So on that basis, the plants has to be classified and then segregate their similar characters and different characters. What in concern morphological concern, external morphological concerns. So external morphological characters are used which have the similar characters segregated in one group, different character on the different group. In this way, one by one he has to be selected up to the next one, or final group has to be not identified in this way. So big groups are divided into a largely on the basis of such characters and then subdivided into a small units or small groups. Therefore the weightage of the characteristics of these morphological characters are most important, and all the possible characters are comes together. Such possible characteristics which are observed, keenly observed in this classification system. So dicot and monocot, take example, dicot and monocot. We look at here the word itself indicating and expressing a particular character. Di means two, cot means cotyledon. Two cotyledons plants are separated, one cotyledons are plant separated differently. So this is a natural variation characters. In addition to that, a leaf structure. Leaf have a venation pattern, exact venation patterns. Reticular venation pattern is present in the dicot group and parallel venation in the monocot groups. So within the angiosperm plants, particularly such types of the classification system has to be made, called as a particular natural one. Further subclasses are separated on the basis of weightage of the corolla character or flower characters. On the basis of these flower characters, they have been divided into three subclasses as a polypetally, that means petals free, then gamopetally, petals are united, apetally or monochlamydia, in which a petals are absent, or these absence of the petals are also particularly present in the presence of whorls. One whorl, that whorl is called as a perianth, called as a tepals. So in this way, so up to the species, it has been to determine and fix their position in the classification system. So it is called as a particular, the natural system classification. We look at the phanerogam seed bearing plant, divided into dicotyledon, gymnosperms and monocotyledon. These are the classes. Seed bearing plants, dicot, monocot. Dicot means two cotyledons, one cotyledons, and third one is here gymnosperm, that is the naked seeds. Then again, the subdivision in subclasses, polypetally, gamopetally, monochlamydia or apetally, on the basis of the flower structure, petals free, united or absence. In this way, the series have been divided and the orders have been divided, and then finally families and the genus and species position has been fixed up. So this is about the phylogen natural order. Third phylogenetic system of classification is nothing but all the characters on the basis of the evolutionary pattern. So research in the plant science has been goes on deeply and deeply to the heart of the plants, and comes a number of new characters from the different branches of the botany, particularly from the anatomy, embryology, physiology, biochemistry, cytology, all the branches has to be also research has to be done. I knew information has been added, therefore new characters has been added. So as per their evolution pattern, such characters are comes out to build up HTM classification. That system is called as phylogenetic system of the classification. Such systems proposed by various scientists, including the Engler and Prandtl, 1895. These are German scientists: Hutchinson, 1942; Takhtajan, 1997. Russian scientist Thorne, Dahlgren. These are the American scientist. Very recently, Dahlgren in 1982 proposed phylogenetic type of the classification system. But no one has to be phylogenetic. Why? Because of science is ever changing. The informations, newly informations has to be added day by day. So new characters are comes out and included in the classification system. That is why API system of the classification is also introduced in modern taxonomy. So all these proposed systems are based on evolutionary tests on the plants and classified based on the phylogenetic relationship, which has to be indicated the sequence of evolution, where primitive and advanced characters are taken into account. Which are the primitive characters? Which are primitive characters in the plant, and which are advanced characters, and then they have been segregated. For example, Engler and Prandtl system of the classification proposed in 1895. Their classification system is very famous at that time, and they give a more weightage to the primitive and the advanced characters. Now the primitive characters we look at here: unisexual naked flowers, which are born catkin type of the inflorescence, are more primitive than the other type of the animals. That means catkin type of the inflorescence is the first inflorescence, and primitive type of the inflorescence in the evolution pattern, and from which they are the racemos and other cymos type of the inflorescence are developed. That is the advanced. Bisexual flowers derived from a cluster of male and female flowers, which are held in unisexual flowers in the same inflorescence axis. So such type of the characters has been considered as a particularly a primitive and advanced. So unisexual flowers has been considered as a primitive one, and bisexual flowers are a advanced one. Monocots are the most primitive, and dicots are derived from the monocots. That means here we have a very different one in the Engler and Prandtl classification, which has been proposed of them. Monocot is the first plant on the earth, and from this monocot, dicots has to be evolved. Another thing is that flowers with perianths are more primitive, and flowers with calyx and corolla are derived. That means very different way here as compared to the natural system of the classification by Bentham and Hooker. Later we discuss in detail in the Bentham and Hooker system of the classification. Why they have been considered as more primitive characters, flowers with the perianth? That means first perianth, that means absence of calyx and corolla. Then slightly change has to be occurred and modified to comes out the new characters. That is the petals and sepals are emerged. So petals and sepals within the flower or corolla is considered as a most advanced one. But all these characters are opposite in the classification system proposed by Bentham and Hooker. And the ovules with axial placentation are more primitive, and others are derived from this axial placentation. So this is about the classification, three types of the classifications and their shortly descriptions. And one by one classification we have studied in this BSc class. Firstly, we have to discuss about the natural system of the classification proposed by Bentham and Hooker in next video. Thank you. सगळे क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टीम्स आपल्याला आहेत, परंतु यावर्षी फक्त बेंथम अँड हुकर्स क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टीम आहे, ती आपण पाहू. आलं लक्षात पुढच्या ह्याच्यामध्ये. थँक्यू.